Hello, this is Kenosis. This work is about tuning a drill press. In a typical drill press, the distance between the fixed shaft and the drill chuck is much shorter than you might think. This is a small drill press for old school use, built to find more than 4 times this distance. Now you can drill accurately and comfortably even in very large wood. Let me show you the process. LLM guide rails and bearings are very useful because they are very strong. It's a bit pricey, but it's an essential material for DIY. This part is where the drill press's shaft is fixed, so I made it very strong. Even though I have quite a few bolts, I can't always find the length I need. I figured out a convenient way to cut multiple bolts to the desired length. This is a hole clamp for use on tables. I use this as a stopper. It seems to work quite well. You guys should try it out too. To secure it firmly, a groove was made using a milling machine. This groove is filled with epoxy to provide a very strong hold. The hole clamp serves well as a stopper. A groove was dug into the wood to support the LM guide rail and prevent it from getting caught in the bearings. This is to ensure that the load is supported across the entire rail. A thin metal plate is used to mount the side stoppers. If you use the stopper bolt on wood, it will cause a groove and hurt. To avoid damaging my sanding base floor, I made a simple drill press floor plate. It can be easily fixed with a clamp. It's done. When drilling a hole in the center of a large piece, a regular drill press won't do the job. The distance between the fixed shaft of the drill press and the drill chuck is very short. I measured my drill presses and they are only about 150 millimeters to 180 millimeters. This piece can be used to perform any desired drilling operation, even in the center of a very large wood. This would seem like a very useful item for those who don't use CNC. As I've said many times, my sanding base collects dust from holes in the bottom and sides. The fan switch activates a large suction vent in the ceiling of the sanding base. The dust switch operates the dust collector. Through this, fine dust is discharged outside, and the dust does not reach my face. The left switch automatically opens the shutter to collect dust from the holes in the floor. The right switch activates the dust collector on the right. The middle switch activates a separate dust collector located in the center. Through this dust collection tube, dust is collected from other equipment used in the sanding base. In the next video, I'll install the dust collection system and wire tracks for this project and create a cover to protect the bearings. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe and like. Thank you.